The COVID-19 pandemic saw disinformation and misinformation run rife. But over time, some conspiracy circles have switched their focus towards extreme climate change denial. And now we're seeing it with Cyclone Gabrielle. Dr. Sanjana Hattotuwa from the Disinformation Project joins us now for more on this. I almost can't believe it. Some people think that a plague of locusts type thing has been sent down by politicians. There are conspiracy theories about the death toll that's not being given to the public. How has this happened to us?
Well, by the time you guys come around to that question, some of us have been observing these developments for a very long time, which seems to be the standard answer whenever I come on the show. So it's not surprising to the Disinformation Project that we are at the stage we are, but there is some violence in trying to explain it in a few seconds. It's a bit like, you know, trying to explain a Puccini opera in 30 seconds. You can do it, but there is more to the tale. What we saw after the sunset of the traffic lights framework, and in particular after the end of the parliament protest last year around this time, was a switch, a shift, and a strategic, sophisticated one at that, of the networks that were, say, around the mandates and the anti-vaccination to older conspiracy theories and frames. Geoengineering, chemtrails, fluoridation, 1080, and a whole range of other things that they then latched onto. I'll end by saying, in response to your first question, that it's not just the old again. These are networks, individuals. These are strategic, very strong, highly sophisticated networks that are following a foreign script and have been emboldened by their success during the pandemic that they're now leveraging for the purposes of disinformation, including around Cyclone Gabrielle, but also previously around the flooding in Auckland and every imaginable natural sudden onset disaster or climate change that will occur in months and years to come.
They're going to be busy. Dr. Hattotuwa, can you tell me, is this about maintaining control or maintaining some followers? Is it about a grift? We've certainly seen people doing some kind of fundraising for these groups.
Well, it's about climate change denialism leading to the entrenchment of individuals in those networks as the saviors and those who have a handle on the truth, who can then give meaning to people who are suffering as a consequence of not preparing for or not believing in or not doing the investments around what is needed to address what is an existential crisis for all of humanity, leave aside Aotearoa New Zealand. So it's about that. It's counterintuitive, and listeners might find this hard to grasp. It's about pushing back on everything that I am saying right now and what you would put out and this program when it goes out on disinformation networks, and then saying, hey, look here, we are here to help. Listen to us. We are coming with the convoys. Don't trust the Red Cross. Don't trust the government. Don't trust NZ Civil Defense. Don't trust anything that the mainstream media says, because we have a handle on it and we will help you. So it's about creating those networks that are now additional and adding on to the networks that were initially around the vaccinations and mandates.
Even though nothing comes true, I have been told to wrap, but just in 30 seconds, because I think it is important, what should we practically do, or is there a solution that we can do? Is it just simply turning off the phone and going outside for a walk at this point?
No, I think you need to kind of realize that this is not an issue that's going to go away. I don't see any kind of guardrails or preparation for the Red Cross, NZ Civil Defense, or the Met services to deal with disinformation around climate change. We have been through the pandemic. We know that this is real, not just with the biological, but with the infection of the mind. And this is now very real in terms of its impact on climate change and the environment. So I think we need to acknowledge that and work around it.
Does not sound like an easy job. Dr. Sanjana Hattotuwa, thank you so much for your time this morning from the Disinformation Project.